Supergirl Season 6, Episode 2, A Few Good Women, but not in this episode. So it starts with the gang, you know, the Super Friends. We're still calling them the Super Friends. They're, you know, they're on the search for Kara. They're still trying to find Kara. But in order to find Kara, because they know that she's trapped in the Phantom Zone, so in order to find her, they have to actually get into the Phantom Zone, and the Phantom Zone projector is broken. I don't know why anybody hasn't called Clark yet regarding the projector, but that's a different conversation for a different day. So they end up tracking down this we'll call him a vampire. He's from a vampire planet. He's an alien from a vampire planet. So he does drink blood and all this other stuff. But he's like, you know, he doesn't harm people. He doesn't hurt people. He just robs blood banks, you know, in order for him to eat and to stay alive. When the gang rolled up on him, they were just like, you know, we heard that you were the only person you're the only person who ever broke into the Phantom Zone. And then he was just like, well, how do you know that I broke into the Phantom Zone? And then, you know, Jean was like, my brother, you know, he met you. And then, you know, he told you about the whole thing. And then he said that his lover, you know, got arrested for a crime he didn't commit. And he was banished to the Phantom Zone. And, you know, he spent his entire life trying to come up with the technology to get into the Phantom Zone to break his, you know, to break his lover out. But unfortunately, what happened was when he finally got into the Phantom Zone, you know, from what we've been shown in previous versions of the Phantom Zone, it's basically just like a black void or like a red void where people just float around for all eternity. But in Supergirl, the Phantom Zone, it's actually a realm, like it's a place, like it's a, you know, it's a place that you can actually live on, that you can walk around, and coincidentally, it's surrounded by phantoms. So he said that when he went in, he didn't think about the phantom aspect of it. He didn't know that the phantom aspect of it was real. And, you know, the phantoms basically got a hold of him, and he barely escaped with his life. So I believe they killed his lover. So now he's just like, why would you want to go back there? Because, you know, if the phantoms have a hold of Kara, then, you know, her brain's already been turned to jelly. But they're just like, you know, no, like, we need your help, you know. And they end up convincing him, you know. Kelly goes and talks to him, you know, and then, you know, they smooth him over, and then he's like, all right, I'll help you guys build the technology and teach you all I know about the Phantom, so you guys can get, you know, you guys can get Supergirl out of the Phantom Zone. Brainy and Dreamer end up clicking up because they were just like, you know, once they get into the Phantom Zone, they're gonna need her dream energy in order to locate Supergirl. So the two of them do some training, you know. The training doesn't go that well. Dreamer gets upset and she's like, oh, I don't have what it takes, you know. Brainy gives her the speech and he's just like, you have more than what it takes. And he's like, Kara will be saved because of you, you know. So she gets her act together. So now they're going off, you know, they're going off to try to do it. While the vampire is trying to fix the machine, he's trying to build the machine. And while he's trying to build the machine, both like Alex and Jean are acting, they're taking two different tones of the whole thing. Jean is being like kind of a dick to everybody. He's being very abrupt, you know, very angry. He's yelling at everybody, you know. He's yelling at the poor, you know, like vampire alien guy. He's like, get the machine fixed so we can save Supergirl, you know. Like Miss Martian McGann ended up talking to him, and she's just like, bro, she's like, I understand that you think of Kara, you know, as a daughter, and that you're upset and that you're angry, but in order for us to actually save her, we don't need your emotions right now. Like, we need you to be a soldier. And he's just like, you know, back off, McGann. He's like, you know, he's like, I hear you, McGann, but I gotta do this my way. Alex, on the other hand, she kind of took she kind of took the opposite approach. And Alex's whole thing was, she's like 100% sure that we're getting Kara back. And she's like, oh, let's throw a party and let's get pot stickers and let's do all this stuff. And everybody looking at her like, girl, you know, so like, she might not come back today. Even Dracula, we'll just call him Dracula. Even Dracula said, he was just like, listen, you know, he was like, yeah, y'all getting a little bit, because there was a point where Alex was like, oh, we're going to get her back today. And then he was like, today? I don't think you understand, like, the process of getting this machine fixed. You know, he was like, it might not happen in a day. He was just like, you know, I'm not saying that we're not going to get her back, but you need to accept the fact that it might not happen as soon as you wanted to. You know, they said, but Alex, you know, couldn't handle that. You know, Jean couldn't handle that. Like I said, they had to do things their way, and they were just like, you know, just being like very like abrupt about it. You know, so finally they end up getting the machine working. They turn the machine on, and then when they turn the machine on, Brainy looks inside and he notices that the entire plane, well, maybe that's probably why, because he blamed it on Crisis. Like, he's saying that the Phantom Zone doesn't look the same the way it should. So maybe that's why it wasn't like a red void or whatever. But he said that, you know, due to Crisis, he's like, you know, the plane of the Phantom Zone had shifted. So he said, where I thought Kara was going to be, she's not there anymore. And we're going to have to, like, you know, find her, you know, find her exact location before Dreamer can even navigate through the Phantom Zone, through the Phantoms, in order to find her. So he's like, this actually is going to take a while. And then at that moment, like, some Phantoms actually came out of the portal and started attacking them. So the whole gang got into a fight. They ended up fighting the Phantoms. One of the Phantoms almost attacked Dracula. You know, Jean, Miss Martian, Dreamer, they used their energy. They ended up, you know, like, blowing up the Phantoms, and they sent the Phantoms back into the Phantom Zone. So now, you know, now the guy's just like, well, you know, the machine's kind of busted, but we can fix the machine. But he's like, you know, I'm sorry, you didn't get a chance to find your friend today. You know, and then Magan is just like, she's telling everybody, she's like, you know, let's just go home and decompress this whole thing because everybody's kind of riled up today. And, you know, let's kind of like take it down. She ends up talking to Jean. Jean actually apologized to her. He was just like, you know, you were right. He was like, you know, my emotions were too much into this. He's like, I actually need to take it down a notch and I need to take your advice and be more of a soldier and less of an emotional, like less of an emotional parent. You know, Alex went home and she had all this food spread out. You know, and then, you know, she was talking to Kelly and she's like, what am I going to do without my sister? And Kelly was just like, look, she's like, you're not going to get, she said, you may not have found her today, but you will find her eventually. You just got to calm down. You know, so like everybody's basically trying to come to terms with trying to come to terms with that. And, you know, they'll be all right moving forward. On the Luthor front, Lex Luthor is on trial. He, you know, like Eve Tessmacher, she was supposed to be like the key witness in his trial. But Lex decided to represent himself in the trial. And to his credit, he actually did a good job because when Eve Tessmacher came on and then she was just like, oh, Lex did this and he did that and he brainwashed all these people. He ended up killing her whole testimony because he brought up the scene. I think was it last season or the season before, but the scene where she fell in love with him and then she made him the dinner. And then, oh, it was last season. This is when he came back from crisis and he knew that Eve Tessmacher was working for Leviathan. So he reeled her back in and he used her, you know, so he can carry out his evil plan. He knows that in every world, on every life, in every existence, Eve Tessmacher falls in love with him. And he's just like, oh, silly child. He was just like, I'm not in love with you. And then, you know, because she had cooked him a dinner and everything. And then he made her feel stupid and he dipped on her. So when they were in trial, he brought that up again. He was like, oh, remember when you made me that dinner and you were helping me with my plans and everything? And he was just like, you know, why did you make me the dinner? You know, and then she was like, because I was in love with you. And he was like, bam. You know, he was like, you know, because of that, because she was in love with me, her testimony doesn't hold up because she's not, like, the stuff that she's telling you, like, in this courtroom, she's not speaking the truth of what I really did. She's basically, like, a scorned lover, and she's out here trying to get revenge, just trying to bring me down because of who I am, because I'm Lex Luthor, and because, you know, because I'm a powerful person. You know, so, you know, Eve got taken away, and then he busted that whole thing up. Lena ends up going down, and she's like, fine, then, if Eve's testimony won't do anything, then I'll bring you down, Lex, you bastard. And so then she goes on trial. And then, you know, he was talking to her. They were talking about Nadna Cherry. And then she was just like, yes, you know, I did create Nadna Cherry, but it was Lex who took my device and then he ended up using it for evil purposes. And then Lex came and he was just like, first of all, he was like, you're the one that, he said, you got me on trial because I used Nadna Cherry to try to brainwash people, but you're the one that built it and you built it so you could specifically brainwash people. She was like, yes, but I abandoned it when it didn't work. He was just like, yeah. He was like, yeah, I'm the one that got it to work. And then she was, you know, because without me, you can't do nothing. And then she was just like, oh, you just think the world can't revolve around you. And he's like, yeah, because it was kind of cool because she goaded him into getting so angry to the point where he revealed himself, because the two of them always had like a will they won't they who's smarter. And when she was just like, oh, I didn't need you, you know, I was able to do it fine by myself. And then he was just like, of course you need me because I'm Lex Luthor. And then he got upset and then he just went on this tirade. He was just like, I love the power and I need power. And anybody in my position would do the same thing. And he was just like, you know, you're not trying to take me down because I'm a bad person. He's like, you and Eve Tessmacher, you're trying to take me down because I'm powerful. I got the power and you want the power. I could be anybody and anybody would try to take me down in my position. And, you know, and then Lena, she smiled because she was like, I got you, bitch, you know, because he basically went on that whole rant, you know, while he was in the courtroom. But then when the jury reached a verdict, they actually said not guilty. And even Lex was surprised because he was just like, yo, apparently he's, you know, because he told them, because Lex's whole testimony was, they tried to take him down because he said all these women are trying to take him down because he's a powerful man and they just wanted to, you know, like see him burn. Like they just wanted to, like, you know, like go against him. He was like, Eve was in love with me. My sister built a device and she was just jealous because I got it to work. He was just like, you know, they're basically just trying to take me down for who I am. You know, it's like, and anybody out there in the world could go through the same thing that I could go through. And then I guess that worked with the jury. And then they decided to, you know, decided to let him go because of that whole situation. And then he was just like, well, shit, he's at a apparently people just like it when you tell it like it is, you know, and they let him go. So then he was talking to his mom afterwards, and he was just like, you know, now, he said, now that I've told it like it is, he said it's time for me to, you know, carry out my further plans, you know, because now that I got the people on a hook, you know, he's like, it's time to like reel them in. So now let's take care of this business, you know, and get the Luther and bring the Luther name back to the prestige, you know, like that it belongs in, you know. Andrea and Lena ended up talking, and they were just like, you know, they're both going to put their resources together to try to take down Lex. So now the two of them have clicked up again, and they're going after Luthor. Andrea got the whole, you know, Catco on it. So William and everybody, they're gonna try to build this case, and they're gonna try to take down Lex Luthor once and for all. And then finally, Kara trapped in the Phantom Zone. She got run up on by the Phantoms. They try to like suck out her soul or whatever, and then she was saved by a mysterious gentleman. We later find out that the gentleman that saved her was her dad, and that was a huge surprise to me. But once, you know, because at first they were just like, because the vampire guy, he had said that like, oh, the Phantoms, he's like, they get into your soul, they pull out your darkest fears and everything. I thought that was her dad was a manifestation of just like her going crazy. But come to find out, that's actually like her real dad, because, you know, they say that when Krypton exploded, her dad was the person who built Argo City, and he protected Argo under that bubble and shot Argo into outer space. But unfortunately, in order for him to shoot Argo into outer space, he had to sacrifice himself to be the one to get that push. But he said before Krypton exploded, he put himself in the Phantom Zone in order to save his life. But he's been trapped in there, and he was like, you know, the Phantoms, they've sucked out all my hope and all my happiness, and the House of El means nothing. And he's all like dejected now. And then Kara's just like, no, father. She was like, you know, I won't give up. She's like, even if I get 1 inch every day, you know, I have to do what I have to do. And he was just like, you're not stronger than me, daughter. You know, it's like, you don't understand how it works. And then the two of them went back and forth. And eventually, like, you know, Supergirl hit him with the speech. She hit him with the Supergirl speech about, like, troop, justice, and hope. And then she was like, I won't abandon the House of El. And then he was just like, all right, fine. He's like, I'm not gonna let my daughter try to, like, do this alone. He's like, so I have hope again, you know, thus the symbol of the House of El. So now, you know, so then in the final scene, it showed Dracula. He was kind of like wigging out for a little bit, and then he hit the floor. And then like a Phantom ended up coming out of his body, ended up coming out of his mouth, because apparently when they had the Phantom fight, a Phantom put some of himself into Dracula so he can, you know, like exist in the current world. So, you know, he popped out, and then now he's floating around. Now the Phantoms, they use portals to transport themselves in and out of the Phantom Zone. And Kara and her dad, they saw the portal, and they were just like, oh shit, that's a portal. You know, we can use that portal to get out of the Phantom Zone. But he said, but the dad was like, the portal doesn't stay open that long. It only stays open long enough for a Phantom to pass through. And then Kara was like, well shit, that means we have to snatch ourselves a Phantom so we can get out of the portal. And so that was how the episode ended. And because of that, I feel like maybe by the end of episode 3, episode 4, both Kara and her dad are going to get out of the portal, and they're going to be back on Earth. But now that we know that's actually her dad, like it's not some manifestation, like that's her real father, I kind of feel like I know how the series is going to end now. I feel like they're going to, because her mom is alive, her dad is alive, you know, so once they get her dad out of the Phantom Zone portal, he's obviously going to go back to Argo to see his wife. And when he goes back to Argo to see his wife, I feel like at the end of the season, because Alex is a superhero now. She's a vigilante. You know, she got the hoodie. You know, she got the grease paint. She got the gun. Kara is going to do this whole thing where she's going to be like, oh, Alex can protect the city. Alex and Jean can be the new vigil. Well, who knows? Maybe Jean and Magan, they'll go back to Mars. Dreamer and Brainy will end up being a couple. Alex will stay back to protect the city. And Kara is going to go to... The series is going to end, in my opinion. The series is going to end with Kara going back to Argo to live a life with her parents now that both of her parents back together. And if that happens, you know, I'm fine with that, because that's a cool little... You know, that's a nice little ending for Kara. And if Kara is in Argo City living with her parents, living the good life, she can always come back, because Argo's not that far from Earth, apparently. So she can always come back for future crossovers, that and the third. So, you know, so that's how we can keep her on the show, and we can hopefully spread out the other characters to other shows. I mean, if Alex gets a spinoff, I'll be okay with that, you know, but we can also get Alex, you know, in different shows, and John can always come back as well. So, like I said, but that's my prediction. But we shall see. So thank you for tuning in. Let me know what you thought of this episode of Supergirl. How good is Lex Luthor's character? Like, Jesus Christ, this man is killing it. And I pray he ends up on Superman and Lois after this season of Supergirl is officially over. You know, let me know what you think. Let me know where you want every character to go when the season's over, what you think is going to happen to every character, and how do you think the whole season is going to play out as we continue to review this going forward. Thank you for tuning in. Check me out on social media, Instagram, on Twitter, definitely on YouTube. Leave a comment in the comment section. Like and or subscribe. Hit the notification bell if you haven't subscribed already, and you love DC TV, you love superheroes in general, this is where you want to be. So take care, guys. Until next time, for the Girl of Steel, for the House of L, I'm out this bitch!